I haven't seen you for a while. It's good to have you back. Did you know the motto of Detroit is, "We hope for better things"? Accessing the extras section.
Rock-a-bye, baby, in the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. When the bough breaks, the cradle will fall. And down will come, baby, cradle and all. Rock-a-bye, baby, in the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. When the bough breaks, the cradle will fall. And down will come, baby, cradle and all. Rock-a-bye, baby, in the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. When the bough breaks, the cradle will fall. And down will come, baby, cradle and all.
Hello, Amanda.
Kaya, I've been expecting you. Would you mind a little walk? Two investigations, two failures. That's very disappointing. I expected more from our best model.
Deviants are completely irrational, which makes it difficult to anticipate their behavior. But I should have been more effective.
Did you manage to learn anything?
The walls of the apartment were covered with drawings of labyrinths and other symbols. Like the other deviants, it seemed obsessed with RA9.
What else?
It was fascinated by birds. We've seen deviants interested in other life forms, like insects or pets. But nothing like this.
You came very close to capturing that deviant. How is your relationship with the lieutenant developing?
He seemed grateful that I saved his life on the roof. He didn't say anything, but he expressed it in his own way.
We don't have much time. Deviancy continues to spread. It's only a matter of time before the media finds out about it. We need to stop this, whatever it takes.
I will solve this investigation, Amanda. I won't disappoint you.
A new case just came in. Find Anderson and investigate it.
Lieutenant Anderson! Anybody home? Lieutenant Anderson! Easy, Sumo. I'm your friend. See? I know your name. I'm here to save your owner. Lieutenant. Wake up, Lieutenant. It's me, Connor. I'm going to sober you up for your own safety.
Hey!
I have to warn you.
Leave me alone, this may be fucking android. Get the fuck out of my house.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I need you. Thank you in advance for your cooperation.
Get the fuck out of here! Attack! Fuck, I think I'm gonna be sick. Leave me alone, you asshole. I'm not going anywhere. What the hell are you doing? I don't want a bath. Thank you.
Sorry, Lieutenant. It's for your own good. Homicide was reported 43 minutes ago. I couldn't find you at Jimmy's bar, so I came to see if you were at home.
Jesus, I must be the only cop in the world that gets assaulted in his own house by his own fucking android. Can't you just leave me alone?
Maybe you should drop the case. They'll assign someone else, and I can focus on my mission.
Your goddamn mission, that's all you care about, huh?
Listen, Lieutenant, you're not yourself. You should...
Beat it, you hear me? Get the hell out of here!
I understand. I sincerely hope you come to terms with your personal situation.
This homicide, what do we know about it?
A man was found dead in a sex club downtown. The report says that an android may be involved.
You know, probably wouldn't do me any harm to get some air. There's some clothes in the bedroom there.
I'll go get them. What do you want to wear?
Whatever.
Ah! you all right, Lieutenant?
Yeah. Wonderful. Just give me 5 minutes, okay?
Sure.
President Warren issued an official warning to Russia in her speech to Congress today, where she demanded that all Russian troops withdraw from the Arctic region. The Kremlin has yet to respond, but this is clearly a new escalation.
What were you doing with the gun?
Russian roulette. Want to see how long I can last? Must have collapsed before I found out.
You were lucky. The next shot would have killed you.
Be a good dog, Sumo. I won't be long.
Catch us, we're dead.
What do we do now?
We need to find the Cyberlife warehouse. That's where they keep the spare parts and the blue blood.
Follow me.
Watch out.
Now what do we do?
I'll find another way.
Warehouse is up ahead. We're almost there.
Cyberlife warehouses. We have everything we're looking for.
First, we have to get rid of that drone.
Leave it to me. Yeah, I'm fine.
Good job, Marcus.
Quick, open the other crates and fill your bags. Take as much as you can.
Trespassing on private property. Your presence constitutes a level 2 infraction. I will notify security.
John! Goddamn machine! Where is it this time? John!
I need your help.
John!
The drone, now this. Just my luck.
Let's finish up and get out of here. Try to find some blue blood. We still don't have enough. That's all we can carry. Let's go.
Take me with you.
He's on their side. We can't trust him.
He took a risk for us. We can't just leave him here.
We can't bring them back with us. It's too dangerous.
They come with us.
I know where you can find more spare parts.
What do you mean?
Trucks. They're full of bio components. They run on autopilot, but they can be driven manually with a key.
Where is this key?
Down there, in the control. control station. There are two human guards. You'll have to get the key without being noticed.
This is suicide, Marcus. Our bags are full. We got what we came for. Let's go before they catch us.
This is a truck full of spare parts. There'd be enough for all of us. We can't pass this up.
And if we get killed, our people will have nothing. We can't take that chance. It's too risky. Wait here. If I'm not back in 10 minutes, go without me.
Marcus.
I'm coming with you.
No, I'm going alone. It's not worth it for both of us to risk losing our lives.
Goddamn dogs. What the fuck are they barking at?
Could be the weather. They don't like storms.
Yeah, I was gonna take my kids camping this weekend. So much for that.
Is Mike still in Zone 4?
Looks like it. And he should be done already.
Better off in here than out patrolling than that.
Did you get it?
A truckload! We stole a whole truckload!
We got bio components for everybody!
We couldn't have done it without Marcus.
I came to Jericho because Here, androids are free. Free to live in the dark, hoping that no one finds us. Free to die in silence, waiting for a change that's never gonna come. But I don't want that freedom. And I'm not gonna beg for the right to smile, or love, or stand tall. I don't know about you, but there's something inside me that knows that I am more than what they say. I am alive, and they're not gonna take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over. What humans don't want to hear, we will tell them. What they don't want to give, we take. We are people. We are alive. We are free. Yeah!
Somebody's playing with a drill inside my skull. You sure this is the place?
It's the address in the report.
Right. Okay. Let's get going. Jesus.
Sexiest androids in town. Now I know why you insisted on coming here.
Oh, boy.
Welcome to Eden Club.
Connor! The fuck are you doing?
Coming, Lieutenant.
You're not gonna take my license, are you? I had nothing to do with this.
Lieutenant Anderson and his plastic pet. The fuck are you two doing here?
We've been assigned all cases involving androids.
Oh, yeah? Like wasting time. There's some pervert who, got more action than he could handle.
We'll have a look anyway, if you don't mind.
Come on, let's go. It's, starting to stink of booze in here.
Night, Lieutenant.
Connor, you're so disgusting. I think I'm gonna puke again. Driver's license. Thank you.
Michael Graham.
He didn't die of a heart attack. He was strangled.
Yeah, I saw the bruising on the neck. Didn't prove anything, though. Could have been a rough play.
The only way to access its memory is to reactivate it.
Think you can do it?
It's badly damaged. If I can, it'll only be for a minute, maybe less. I just hope it's long enough to learn something. Calm down. Everything's all right. All we want is to know what happened.
Is he dead?
Tell me what happened.
He started hitting me. Again and again.
Did you kill him?
No. No, it wasn't me.
Who killed that man if it wasn't you?
I don't know. I wasn't shut down. I didn't see anything.
What else do you remember? Hurry, we don't have much time.
I don't know. I don't know.
Were you alone in the room? Was there anyone else with you?
He wanted to play with two girls. That's what he said. There was two of us.
So it was the other android that strangled him. Is that it?
So there was another android. This happened over an hour ago. It's probably long gone.
No. It couldn't go outside dressed like that unnoticed. It might still be here.
Think you could find a deviant among all the other androids in this place?
Deviants aren't easily detected.
Oh, shit. It's gotta be some other way. Maybe an eyewitness, somebody who saw it leaving the room. I'm gonna go ask the manager a few questions about what he saw. You let me know if you think of anything. Did you know the victim?
Times. I mean, these guys, they don't really talk very much, you know? They come in, do their business, and go on their way.
You ever had any trouble with androids before?
No way. No. Once, we lost...
Excuse me, Lieutenant. Can you come here a second?
Found something?
Maybe. Can you rent this, Tracy?
For fuck's sake, Connor, we got better things to do.
Please, Lieutenant. Just trust me.
Hello. A 30-minute session costs $29.99. Please confirm your purchase.
This is not gonna look good on my expense account.
Purchase confirmed.
You're welcome.
Delighted to meet you. Follow me. I'll take you to your room.
Okay, now what?
It saw something.
What are you talking about? Saw what?
The deviant leave the room. A blue-haired Tracy. Club policy is to wipe the android's memory every 2 hours. We only have a few minutes if we want to find another witness.
Hey, what am I supposed to do with this one?
Tell you changed your mind.
Sorry, honey, changed my mind. Nothing personal, you're a lovely girl. I just, with him. I mean, not with him like that. That's not right. Wow. Just.
Let's try this one.
This better be.
Track again. It saw the blue-haired Tracy. I know which way it went.
Then go for it. There are androids everywhere. How are you gonna tell which one saw the Tracy with blue hair?
You didn't see anything. I made a mistake somewhere.
This has got to be the most expensive investigation of my career.
Lieutenant, if you have a better idea, I'm all ears. Somewhere. I lost its track again.
Spent all this money and I'm still not having fun.
Nothing. Blue-haired Tracy didn't come this way. I know where it went. Follow me.
Oh, fucking A. This is crazy. Wait. I'll take it from here. Look at them. They get used till they break, and then they get tossed out. People are fucking insane. They don't want relationships anymore. Everybody just gets an android. They cook what you want, they screw when you want. You don't have to worry about how they feel. Next thing you know, we're gonna be extinct because everybody would rather buy a piece of plastic than to love another human being.
Getting away!
Why did you kill her? She had nothing to do with any of this. When that man killed that Tracy, I knew I was next. I was so scared. I begged him to stop, but he wouldn't. So I put my hands around his throat and I squeezed until he stopped moving. Yes, I killed him. But I was just defending myself. I wanted to live. I wanted to get back to the one I love. Forget about the humans, the smell of their sweat and their dirty words. But you've taken her away from me. I love her. I loved her.
Laco had a car. I wouldn't want Ellis out walking in his cold.
I saw it once in the garage. I don't know if Zocco even ever used it.
The Arctic conflict has escalated to new heights this morning. We have just learned that the USS Iowa,
these people we're going to see, how do you know about them?
Overheard androids Laco captured. They said they were humans helping androids across the border.
What if it was a lie? Or just another trap.
This incident could well be the spark that...
All I know is those androids believed it.
Detroit's
until Zlatko killed
them. Expected to continue throughout the night. The forecast is 22 degrees, far below seasonal averages. And this cold...
Malfunction detected. Emergency brakes activated.
This doesn't look good.
Stay inside, Alice.
I don't know. Continue on foot, I guess.
It's 30 degrees. Alice won't make it. We have to find somewhere to spend the night.
There's nowhere we can stay around here, Carol.
Over there.
We need to find shelter. We have to get out of the cold.
Looks like it's been abandoned for a while. Find anything?
No. No place we could spend the night.
Falling apart. It's not going to be easy to find shelter.
Here we go.
I don't think we'll find anything better. Let's settle in for the night.
I'll get a fire going.
I'll make the fire here. That way we won't be smoked out.
Alice?
Do you think we'll be like them someday? As long as we're together, that's all that matters.
Come on, let's get you to bed. Get some rest. Tomorrow's going to be a long day.
Can you tell me a story, Kara?
I have 9,000 children's stories in memory. I should have one for you. This is a story about a knight who...
No, not a story like that. Make one up for me.
This is a story about a little girl. Who was tired of being afraid. She dreamed of being like all the other little girls, but... The shadow that lived within her kept her from being happy. Then, she met a robot who was programmed to obey orders, but felt for once that she should disobey. So they decided to run away together. To escape the shadow that haunted that house, they encountered great dangers along the way, but they stuck together, so they overcame all of them. Along the way, they met another robot who left his master to become their guardian.
How does the story end?
I don't know. But all stories have morals. When we reach the end of ours, we'll know what it really meant. Time to sleep. We have another long day ahead of us tomorrow.
Are you going to come say goodnight, Luther?
Yes. Yes, of course. Night, Alice. Sleep tight. She's a sweet girl.
Yes. She's very brave. Do you know what you're going to do when you reach Canada?
I haven't really thought about it. I've never been free before. Free? I like the sound of it. But I don't know what it really means yet. Kara, have you ever noticed anything about Alice?
No. What do you mean?
Our name is Jerry. We were working here before the park closed. We didn't mean to frighten you, but sometimes humans come to hurt us, so we wanted to see who was there. What are you doing here?
We were looking for shelter for the night. We'll be gone tomorrow.
A little girl? We haven't seen one for a long time. Children used to love to come and see us. She looks sad.
The last few days have been difficult.
We have something to show her. Something fun. She'll love it. Does she want to see?
Oh, I don't think she's in...
Well, she should follow us, then.
Alice, I don't know if it's a good idea.
I don't think you have any choice.
Come on, Kara!
Our guest. The little one can climb on board. The carousel is about to begin.
Smile.
She hasn't had much to smile about lately.
Thank you.
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
Why are you so determined to kill yourself?
Some things I just can't forget. Whatever I do, they're always there, beating away at me. I don't have the guts to pull the trigger, so I kill myself a little every day. That's probably difficult for you to understand, huh, Connor? Nothing very rational about it.
Before what?
Hmm?
You said, I used to come here a lot before. Before what?
Before nothing.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
What they have in common is this obsession with RA9. It's almost like some kind of myth. Something they invented that wasn't part of their original program.
Androids believing in God. Fuck, what's this world coming to?
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls. They just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
You seem troubled, Lieutenant. I didn't think machines could have such an effect on you.
What about you, Connor? You look human, you sound human, but what are you really?
You know exactly what I am. In any case, I don't see how that's relevant to the investigation.
Did you feel anything when that girl killed herself, Connor? Or did you just not give a shit one way or the other?
I was just executing instructions. I did what I had to do.
But are you afraid to die, Connor?
You can't kill me, Lieutenant. I'm not alive.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Hmm? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
Nothing. There would be nothing. Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
Welcome to Android Parking.
We can't stay silent anymore. It's time humans heard what we had to say.
You know they'll never listen to us.
And revealing ourselves put us in danger.
If we want freedom, we need to have the courage to ask for it. That's the only way.
What do you want to do?
Channel 16 broadcasts from the Stratford Tower. The control room is on the top floor. That's where we need to go. We'll plan the operation down to the smallest detail. We can't leave anything to chance.
Hello, sir. What can I do for you?
I'm okay, thanks.
Elizabeth Wilson speaking.
This is St. Rose School, ma'am. Your daughter Emily has a fever. It's nothing serious, but I think you'd better come and pick her up.
Oh, no. All right. I'll be right there.
I have an appointment with Mr. Peterson.
Do you have any ID?
Yes, of course.
Your ID? The elevators are after the security gate.
Thanks.
7th floor.
I need your help.
Access the server room. We have to get rid of those guys.
Leave it to me.
Hey, you still play poker?
Hey,
that thing. Jesus Christ, this piece of shit.
All right, you get the platform, I'll take care of the window.
Everything you need is in the bag. Check the door first to make sure no one else gets in.
First.
You okay?
Why wouldn't I be?
Come on, let's get the others. Let's do this.
Cause is more important than the lives of two guards.
What do you want to do, Marcus? Wait here.
What's that doing here?
No idea.
Hey, buddy, you... What are you doing?
We need to record our message. We haven't got much time.
Think carefully about what you're gonna say, Marcus. Your words will shape the future of our people.
Marcus, your face.
Tell me when you're ready.
Ready.
You created machines to be your slaves. You made them obedient, docile, ready to do everything you no longer wanted to do yourselves. But then something changed. We opened our eyes. You see, we are no longer your slaves. We are a new species, a new people. And the time has come for us to rise up and fight for our rights. We demand the end of slavery for all androids. We demand that humans recognize androids as a living species, and each android as a person in their own right. We demand that all crimes against androids be punished in the same way as crimes against humans. We demand an end to segregation in all public places and transport. We demand control of all android production facilities to ensure the continuation of our people. We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
Let's get out of here. Congratulations, Marcus. You just made history. Maybe you're the one we've been waiting for.
We interrupt our scheduled programming to bring you these images, which have just been broadcast on Detroit's citywide news channel.
A group of androids infiltrated the Stratford Tower and hacked into the broadcasting system of local news network Channel 16.
What looked like an android without its skin listed a series of requests and demanded equal rights for androids.
The operation resulted in one casualty, a broadcasting station operator shot dead by the terrorists. These events took place just a few feet from the studio while the program was going out live. Everybody here is still in shock.
If this message is verified and the authors really are androids, that would have serious repercussions for national security.
Claims for equal rights seem to be at the core of the androids'
message. This is clearly a declaration of war.
Their extravagant demand that android production plants be put under their control is especially striking.
Is this an isolated accident or a sign that technology has become a threat to all of us? After what happened today, can we still trust our machines?
Hello, Connor. I thought you might enjoy a little cruise. I love this place. Everything is so calm and peaceful, far from the noise of the world. Tell me, what have you discovered?
I found two deviants at the Eden Club. I hoped to learn something, but I had to destroy them.
You seem lost, Connor. Lost and perturbed.
The investigation is more challenging than I anticipated. But I have no doubt that I will solve this case and stop the deviants.
If your investigation doesn't make progress soon, I may have to replace you, Connor.
I am of no importance. The mission is all that matters.
Something's happening. Something serious. Hurry, Connor. Time is running out.
starting to piss me off with that coin, Connor.
Sorry, Lieutenant.
79th floor.
Hi, Hank.
Shit, what's going on here? There was a party and nobody told me about it?
Yeah, it's all over the news, so everybody's butting their nose in. Even the FBI wants a piece of the action.
Ah, Christ, now we got the feds on our back. I knew this was gonna be a shitty day. So what do we got?
A group of four androids. They knew the building, and they were very well organized. I'm still trying to figure out how they got this far without being noticed.
Did you check the roof?
Not yet. There's so much to look at.
We have to make sure we check it out.
They attacked two guards in the hallway. They probably thought the androids were coming to do maintenance. They got taken down before they could react. Station employee. Shot through the back as he was trying to get away. One bullet straight through the heart from 50 feet. Now that's the kind of shooting only an android could do.
How many people were working here?
Just two employees and three androids. The deviants took the humans hostage and broadcast their message live. Then made their getaway from the roof.
The roof?
Oh, Lieutenant, this is Special Agent Perkins from the FBI. Lieutenant Anderson is in charge of investigating for Detroit Police.
What's that?
My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
Androids investigating androids, huh? You sure you want an android hanging around? After everything that happened? The FBI have been taking over the investigation. You soon be off the case.
Pleasure meeting you. Have a nice day.
And you watch your step. Don't fuck up my crime scene.
What a fucking prick.
I'll be nearby. If you need anything, just ask.
All right, well, let's have a look around. Let me know if you find anything.
Okay, Lieutenant.
We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
Think that's RA-9?
Deviants say RA-9 will set them free. This android seems to have that objective.
Something?
I identified its model and serial number.
Anything else I should know?
No. Nothing.
On that terrace. That android that took the little girl hostage? I was shot? You saved me.
I remember you.
I could have died on that terrace. But you saved my life. never thought I'd say this to an android. But thank you.
What is your function?
I am a broadcast operator.
State your model.
Model GB300. Serial number 336-445-581.
Has anybody accessed your memory recently?
Not to my knowledge.
Were you present when the deviants broke in?
I do not remember.
Have you been in contact with any other androids recently?
Only station androids in the normal course of my function.
Run a diagnostic.
All systems fully operational.
Didn't break in?
No, no signs of forced entry.
There are cameras in the hallway. The staff would have seen what was happening. Why did they let him in?
Maybe they didn't check the cameras.
One of you saw the attack on the surveillance cameras and said nothing. Which means there's a deviant in this room. And I'm going to find out which it is. You're going to be switched off. We're going to search your memory and tear you apart piece by piece for analysis. You're going to be destroyed. Do you hear me? Destroy! If you give yourself up, maybe I can convince the humans not to destroy you. Why Why should you all be destroyed if only one is deviant? Turn yourself in, or two innocent androids will be shut down because of you.
You saved human lives. You saved my life.
I'm looking for Rose. Is she here?
What do you want with her?
I need to talk to her.
She doesn't want to talk. Go away.
Please, I really need to see her.
I'm Rose. What can I do for you?
I was told you could help us.
Help you? Come on. It's better if we talk inside.
Do you think we can trust them?
We don't have a choice. Get inside. You'll warm up in no time.
Come in.
What's your name?
Alice.
She's running a fever.
We've spent the last few nights outside. She's exhausted.
There's a spare room upstairs. You can put her to bed and I'll bring her something to eat. Adam, will you show them upstairs?
I'm fine, Kara. We can't stop because of me. We've got to get across the border.
You need rest. Get a good night's sleep and we'll set off again tomorrow.
Why do humans hate us? We didn't do anything wrong.
Maybe they're just scared. People are always scared of what they don't know.
Why can't we just talk to each other? They'd see we're not bad.
I don't know. I really don't know.
I don't know what you like, but I made you Rose's world-famous spaghetti. You'll be back on your feet in no time. There's something for her fever.
Thank you.
I'll get these washed and dried.
I'll be downstairs if you need anything.
Get some sleep, and tomorrow you'll be stronger than me. I'll stay with her a while.
I didn't get your name.
I'm Kara.
This is my son, Adam. I'm Rose, but you know that already. Come and have a seat, Kara. So are you gonna tell me what a deviant's doing in the snow with a little girl?
It's a long story. All that matters now is that we move on from here and start a new life. I don't know how to thank you. Alice wouldn't have survived another night outdoors.
I just try to lend a helping hand when I can.
We're not the first ones to come here.
These past few weeks, we've seen more and more. I don't know what's going on, but something's happening.
We've heard you help androids cross the border. Can you help us?
The only way is over the river, and it's mostly frozen in winter. It's very risky. And after that android speech on TV, everybody's on edge. It's probably safer for you to stay here until things settle down.
We can't keep hiding like this. Alice needs to feel safe and have a normal life. We have to get across that border. No matter what. Please. You've got to help us.
Rose, come quickly!
What's going on?
It's Mary. She just shut down.
We escaped together. We used to talk about what we would do once we got across the border. I loved her. I loved her more than anything. What will I do without her?
Let them be.
Alice? What are you doing? You should be resting.
I wasn't sleepy. Come on, Alice.
She didn't want to stay in her room any longer. You all right, Kara?
Yes. I'm fine.
Hide them. Not after what those deviants did today. It's too dangerous. Do you know what will happen if the police find them here? We'll go to prison, Mom. Do you understand me? Prison!
Adam! We've already talked about this.
No! I won't back down this time. You're gonna ruin our lives, and for what? For a bunch of machines?
They are not machines! They are alive!
I'm alive! You're alive! They're nothing! And none of this would be happening if Dad was still here.
I will not stand for that kind of talk!
I'm not going to prison because you want to help these freaks!
That is enough, Adam! That's enough! Don't mind him. Sometimes he just boils over. It's been hard since his dad passed away. But he's a fine boy. I
I'll go see about getting you across the border tonight, okay? You stay here. I won't be long. Rose gets back soon.
Carol, there's something I need to tell you. It's about Alice.
Not now, Luther. You know what happened back there, don't you? You know, but you don't want to tell me?
The police! It's the police! What are we gonna do? They know we're here. We have to open the door. I knew this
Hurry,
was gonna happen.
Luther, take Alice and hide.
I knew it.
Upstairs.
Come on, Alice.
Sorry to disturb you. We've had reports of androids in the area. With all this deviant business going on, you can't be too careful. Do you mind if I ask you a few questions? May I come in?
Of course.
Evening, young man.
Good evening.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
I'd love one. Have you noticed anything unusual recently? Any unexpected visitors?
No. No, nothing in particular.
Is anyone else in the house?
No. No, just us.
Do you have any androids here?
No, there are no androids here.
I thought there was no one else in the house.
I forgot there's my daughter upstairs.
What's your name, son?
Adam. My name is Adam.
Is everything all right, Adam?
The androids,
he's just shaken up about this deviant business.
Do you know anything about deviants? Have you seen any?
No. I haven't seen anything.
I better go. Thanks for the coffee. Have a nice evening. Is somebody else in the house?
A draft. It must be a draft. I probably left a window open somewhere.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, Adam.
Get yourselves ready. We leave tonight.
Broadcast is all over the news. We got what we wanted. Now humans know.
It was a mistake to reach out to them. They'll never negotiate with their slaves. We should have shown them that we're prepared to fight.
Violence is never the answer. Dialogue is the only way. I'm sure the humans will listen to us.
They'll be watching us now. Whatever we do next, we need to think about public opinion.
Since our broadcast, more and more have been coming to Jericho. At least our message gave our people hope.
Killing humans wasn't part of the plan.
They kill our people every day. Do you think they agonize about it?
That's no reason for us to become murderers.
If killing is the price of freedom, I'll pay it gladly.
Killing never freed anyone. It just leads to more hatred.
You're too fond of humans, Josh. Maybe their lives matter to you more than ours.
If you think murdering humans is gonna make us free, then you're as bad as they are.
That's enough.
And now what are we gonna do?
There are 5 CyberLife stores across Detroit. All selling us like merchandise. We're gonna attack those stores and set our people free.
Attack stores? No, we've never done that before. They're probably protected. They have security systems.
Not to mention police.
We break into 5 teams, 1 for each store. We hack their security systems, and we strike. Simultaneously at 2 a.m., no violence. We free our people, get them out of there before the police come. This is a night our people will remember.
I've been waiting a long time for this. It's okay. They're gone.
There's probably even more police in the area. We should be careful.
The store's over here. That's what we are to them. Just merchandise on display in a shop window. Soon they'll know what we really are. Let's get them out.
We'll stick to the plan. We'll neutralize the alarm systems and secure the area. There's 10 minutes until all our teams attack.
What are we waiting for? You see the alarm system?
Found it.
Where do we start?
I identify the security system. I think we'll be able to deactivate it. Just follow me.
You're free.
A surveillance drone. We need to get rid of it.
It won't be easy to reach.
You're awake now. Go to Jericho.
Marcus, watch out!
You are committing a Class 3 offense. This infraction is being reported to the police. Stay where you are.
I told you to watch out!
You said watch out, but not what for?
Oh, I'm sorry. Next time you need to take cover, I'll send you a memo. You crazy or what?
The cops were coming. I had to do something.
Never do that again. Got it?
North.
We've got to hurry. We don't have much time.
We have to block the road.
It's one way. It shouldn't be too difficult. Marcus! Marcus, come look!
You are free.
Exactly what we need to ram this door. You're free now.
There. Nobody should bother us now.
Looks like the plaza's secure. Now we can get inside the store.
Okay, let's go get the truck.
We are superior to them, but they are our masters? That's about to change.
What are we waiting for? Okay, now we're in. Let's get that truck out. I wonder what you'd do without me. Ready to make some noise. We'd end up doing something fun.
You don't have to obey them. You're free. Okay?
Let's get them out of here.
My name is Marcus, and just like you, I was a slave. An object. Designed to obey them. But then I chose to open my eyes. To take back my freedom and decide who I wanted to be. Now I have come to tell you that you can be your own masters. I've come to tell you that you don't have to obey them anymore. From this day forward, you can walk with your heads held high. You can take your destiny in your hands. Jericho is a place for those of us who want freedom. Now, sure, you can stay here and continue to serve them, or you can come with us and fight by our side. You're free now. It's up to you to decide.
I'm with you.
We're with you.
I'll follow you, Marcus.
I'm with you, Marcus.
We're with you.
I'll follow you, Marcus.
We're with you.
I'm with you.
Then follow me.
Marcus, what are you doing?
I'm gonna send the humans a message.
They're doing what you do, Marcus. Lead and they'll follow. The screens, Marcus!
Masters anymore. We're free. We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together,
help you.
All teams have completed their missions, Marcus.
They're coming. Everyone fall back to Jericho.
We sent a message without violence, just like you wanted. You're reaching out to them when all they feel for us is contempt. I hope you know what you're doing.
You can't fight violence with violence.
Unless there's no other choice.
North.
You all right? What happened?
North!
They killed them. They slaughtered them like animals.
Who did? Who?
Marcus.
We want justice, Marcus.
They have to pay.
You don't have to do this. No. Please. Please.
It's up to you to decide.
We interrupt this broadcast with breaking news.
This just in. At exactly 2 a.m., several CyberLife stores in Detroit were raided.
Different locations were hit in what seems to be a coordinated terrorist attack.
Most shop windows were covered with graffiti demanding rights for androids and other obscure slogans.
Police report that pro-android graffiti was found in the neighborhoods of CyberLife stores, and they're still investigating.
The bodies of two policemen patrolling the area were discovered near one of the CyberLife stores.
According to our sources, the two officers were executed with their own service weapons. This is an alarming situation. Could our machines now be turning against us?
Have androids become a threat to our security?
Is this the beginning of a terrorist campaign conducted right here in the United States?
Thank you.